We're here at the 2011 Los Angeles Fitness Expo with MMA Worldwide Magazine publisher Bobby Pittman. Bobby, you guys have been involved with the event for several years now, and you've developed this MMA section for us. Tell us what is here, what's entailed with the whole project.
Right, basically when the fans come out, we want to show them, you know, a good taste of MMA. Obviously showcase the athletes. We got Sean Sherk, we had James Wilkes from The Ultimate Fighter, Mike Guymon from the UFC. So give them a good taste of the athletes, bring some of the girls out, and then we just set up a lot of the equipment that really gets the people excited. The mats, a lot of the workout equipment. They love to see the people swing the sledgehammers around, things like that. The cage is obviously the main attraction, and as soon as the guys, you know, start climbing the stairs and getting there, that's when the crowd forms. Got our tour bus and, you know, the displays and everything. So we just give people a good taste of the lifestyle and what's going on with the fighters.
Bobby, a few people have come to us and said that some of the more innovative and interesting new products were found in this section, talking about masks and equipment. Can you elaborate on some of those and tell us what's featured here?
Yeah, the one last year that really got people and that you see behind me, the War Machine. It's a suspension training system, and you know, they say pull the pin. Once you pull that pin, it engages the core, and so a lot of people like to jump on that. With Sean Sherk, they brought out their Elevation Training Mask, and basically it cuts off your air supply, so it simulates training at high altitudes. And the demo yesterday, we had some fans come out and try on the masks, and they were gassed out pretty quick. So between War Machine, Burn Machine, Stroops, you know, this area here, it's some pretty tricky stuff that a lot of these athletes use to take their training to very, very high levels.
And then finally, what do we got to look forward to coming out in the future issues of the magazine? Any special features or highlights or stories that everyone's going to want to read about?
Yeah, yesterday we did our search for the next Miss Tap Out. So we found our winner. Today we're going to do the search for Miss MMA Worldwide. So both the magazines are going to have a feature from the girls that got crowned here at the Expo. We're doing some great stuff with Sean Sherk. We got a lot of interviews coming out, you know, on the Expo. Talked to Jamie Easton yesterday about doing some stuff, Carmen Electra. So, you know, picking up a lot of great stuff here at the Expo. Obviously going to get some pictures from Rose Gracie over there from her tournament, and, you know, give a good write-up on some of the super fights. So, yeah, a lot of good coverage this year.
So if you had to send a message out to all the MMA Worldwide fans and readers out there about the Expo for next year, what would you tell them?
I said the same thing last year. There's not an expo like this. From not just the fans, but the vendors as well. We have Casey from, you know, Sean Sherk's Elevation Training Mask said that in one day here, he killed all their sales from the Boston UFC Expo. So they moved a lot of product, so it's good for the vendors. As far as the fans, you get to come out and interact. We don't close anything off. Get out here and get your picture taken with these guys, but it's not stand in line. It's just come hang out with us. That's what MMA Worldwide's always been about. That's why we have the tour bus. We roll into these towns and just give people you know, an opportunity to live the life that we live. And it's pretty special to a lot of people that only get that once a year.
Well, Bobby, we certainly appreciate the support and everything you put into this. Thank you so much. We look forward to doing it again next year.
Thank you, guys.